God to step into our heart in this message on this event. I'll never forget going to Washington, D.C., and we've been to the Washington Memorial. The first time I went there, it's almost like you cross a line from the open field as you walk to the memorial. And it's almost like a feeling of almost like a power that you cross this line and just everything stops. I felt that where people just didn't talk. There's something that is beyond words there. And sometimes we come to church, we see family, and it's beautiful. But sometimes our words get in the way. So I'm going to ask for the next 5 minutes before we start our service for us to be still. And to open your heart so we don't become bystanders or entertained in theater, but we become participants with the saints. So a little bit quiet if you can, as best you can, put your prayer hat on your heart, and let's be a little bit still. Let's thank God for your life, your family, your friends, and the gift that we even offer to you in this resurrection. And just have that silence and precious prayer. Thank you. response in the sense we have. So may we participate with love, with our voices, with our bodies, our minds, as we glorify our God who loves us so much. And in Hades to conquer death. Blessings regard on ever and in the ages of
eternal.
Glory to you, Latter Hope, Lord, to you, Heavenly King, Comforter, the Spirit of the Scripture, everywhere present, we fill all things. Treasure your blessings and giver of life, come and dwell in us and plant us the very stain and save our souls with gracious ones.
Amen. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, be gracious to us in our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, consider our weaknesses and heal your fear and sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Glory to the Father,
and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, into the ages of ages.
Amen. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
Come, let us worship and bow down to our King and our God. Come, let us worship and bow down to Christ, our King and our God. Come, let us worship and bow down to Christ himself, our King and our God. Together, have mercy on me, O God, in the greatness of your love, in the abundance of your tender mercies, why help my offense? Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I am well aware of my iniquity, and my sins before me always. It is you alone I have offended. I have done what is evil in your sight. Wherefore you are justified in your charges, and triumphant in your judgment. Behold, I was born in iniquities, and in sins my mother conceived me. But you are a lover of truth. You have shown the hidden depths of your wisdom. Sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be pure. Cleanse me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Let me hear sounds of joy and feasting. The bones that were afflicted shall rejoice. Turn your face away from my offenses, and wipe off all my sins. A spotless heart create in me, O God. Renew a steadfast spirit in my breast. Cast me not away from your face. Take not your blessed spirit out of me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation. And let your guiding spirit dwell in me. I will teach your ways to the sinner, and the living shall return to you. Deliver me from blood guilt, O God, my saving God, and my tongue will joyfully sing your justice. O Lord, you open my lips, and my mouth shall declare your praise. I do desire sacrifice, I would have offered it, but you will not be satisfied with whole burnt offerings. Sacrifice to God is a contrite spirit, a crushed and humble heart God will not spurn. In your kindness, O Lord, be bountiful to Zion. May the walls of Jerusalem be restored. Then will you delight in proper oblation, in sacrifice and whole burnt offering.
gates of life by your burial, and by your death, put death to death, Hades to death.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Pascha, bless your being, seeing you enthroned, and those of the nether world, seeing you entombed, were shaken by your death, O Savior, for you were seen, wonder of wonders, the sovereign of life as dead.
Now and always and forever and ever, amen.
To fill all things with your glory, you dwelt in the bowels of the earth. For my kinship with Adam was no secret to you, and being bearing the loving Lord, you recreated me out of corruption.
When creation beheld you suspended at the place of the skull, who suspended the entire cross freely upon the water, it was sealed with wonder, proclaimed, "Now is holy, save you, O Lord."
Glory to you, our God, glory to you.
Yet, oh, powerful, when he shrank at the awesome sight.
becoming is Adam, falling supernaturally in life-giving sleep. You awaken life from sleep and death as the Almighty.
Jonah was contained in the bosom of a whale, but not held, rather prefiguring his suffering and given over to burial. He sprang out of the beast as from a chamber, shouting to the men on watch, falsely in vain do you keep, for you have forsaken mercy.
Glory to you, our God, glory to you.
The slave you're not parted from the bond you shared with us, for while your temple was torn down at the hour of your passion, your divinity and your flesh remained as one. You exist in both as Son, as Word of God, as God and man.
Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Salvation of us who sing.
Blessed are you, all.
tomb's grave, for seeing him naked and dead, the God of all, he asked leave to bury him, crying,
"You useless him, you disgrace him, and you people exalt him to the ages, now and always and forever and ever, amen."
What unknown wonders, what goodness, what indescribable forbearance, he who dwells in the highest, willingly is sealed under the earth, and God himself is accused as a fraud.
You useless him, you disgrace him, and you people exalt him to the ages. We praise him, bless him, we worship the Lord.
Be astonished in all you heavens, and let the earth's foundation quake, for behold the one who dwells in the heavens is reckoned among the dead and is a watcher in a small tomb.
You bless him, you disgrace him, and you people exalt him to the ages.
Do not lament for me, Mother, as you see me in the tomb. The Son you conceive without seed, for I will rise and be glorified, and those who in faith and devotion magnify you ceaselessly, as God I will rise up to glory.
Glory to you, our God, glory to you.
Eternal Son, spared the travail of your wondrous birth, I was wondrously blessed, but now my God, as I see you breathless and dead, I am grievously pierced by the sword. yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, into the ages of ages. So beautiful to see everyone here. In our Orthodox tradition, we have shepherds, that the shepherd priests and you, and Metropolitan Gerasimos is our shepherd in San Francisco, and Patriarch Bartholomew is our shepherd, overall shepherd in Constantinople. He offers you this message. You will have a prayer cast as offered. So whatever you have to offer, that would be great. We are grateful for your generosity throughout the year. Visitors, we're blessed to have you. May you be filled with God's Spirit as we pray through this way. From Metropolitan Gerasimos. And he said to them, do not be amazed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who is crucified. He is risen, he is not here. See the place where they laid him. Dearly beloved, we have reached the goal of our Lenten and Holy journey of Holy Week. Today we approach the tomb of our Lord and Savior, and like the women in the Gospel, we find it empty. Only an angel is present, a messenger of God telling us he is not here, he is risen. This is a simple message, a few words, yet one that not only transformed the disciples, but transformed the world. The Jesus Christ was born in Bethlehem of Mary, had lived among his people, taught them with great authority, healed their ailments, forgave their sins, so they would experience the love of God the Father, and yet was rejected by these same people and suffered a most horrible death on the cross and buried in a borrowed tomb and had risen from the dead. As St. Gregory the Theologian states so profoundly, we needed an incarnate God, a God to put to death that we might live. We were put to death together with him that we might be cleansed. We rose again with him because we were put to death with him. We are glorified with him because we rose again with him. Our proclamation of the resurrected Christ is the core of our Christian Orthodox faith. St. Paul said to the Corinthians, if Christ has not been raised, listen. If Christ has not been raised and our preaching is in vain, and your vain is in vain, and then your faith is in vain. Corinthians 1:15, verse 14. Every tenet of the Orthodox Christianity must be brought back to our faith in Jesus Christ and his triumph over death. From our understanding of God as Trinity and Jesus as the Son of God, to our understanding of the Church and how we are to live as Christians today. All these and more began in the experience and witness of the disciples of the risen Lord. This is the apostolic faith we maintain and proclaim throughout the ages. Proclaiming Christ is at the heart of our Church and the life of our community. Everything we do as a Church must reflect Jesus Christ, his life, his teachings, his care for humanity, and his death and resurrection. Our communal and personal behavior must be consistent with our words and claims to be followers of Christ. Our liturgical life is focused on Christ. Our educational and philanthropic life must reflect Christ. Our outreach and evangelism must proclaim Jesus Christ. As St. Peter wrote so many centuries ago to Christians who did not know Jesus, and Peter knew him, said, without having seen him, you love him, though you do not know, now see him,
you believe in him and rejoice with unutterable exalted glory. 1 Peter 1, verse 8. And yet we have seen Christ's resurrection, we hear the good news, and we are there at the empty tomb. We have become witnesses of the risen Christ and have put our trust in him and his teaching. And for this reason, our Paschal season is filled with baptismal references, reminding us of the commitment we made to Christ at our own baptism. Did you make that commitment? You're babies. So hopefully we're making that commitment every time we come here. The candles we hold at Pascha for the next 40 days are the same candles that were held at your baptism. Then and now we made a commitment to following and proclaiming the light of Christ in the world filled with darkness. This is why St. Paul said and told the Christians in Ephesus, "Now you are light in the Lord, walk as children of the light." My note to you, are we walking as children of the light? The invitation is for you today to do it. We proclaim the resurrection of Christ in the safety of our country. Our church lives in freedom, but for countless Orthodox Christians in the world and other Christians, raising their Paschal candles, proclaiming their faith in Jesus Christ, and participating in the life of church indeed, even just attending is filled with risk and mortal danger. What would you do if the military came in and said, "Are you a Christian?" If you are, we're going to be in trouble. That's what's happening right now. These are today's martyrs, holding up the light of their faith in places that seek to extinguish it. These are the new saints, witnesses for their faith, willing to accept their fate while still striving for peace and understanding with those who do not believe. In these days of celebration, remember your brothers and sisters who live under these conditions. Pray for them, St. Paul said. Be watchful, stand firm in your faith, be courageous, be strong. Let all that you do be done in love. And so when you gather with family and friends this Pascha, share your faith as well as your hospitality. Share the joy that the good news of the resurrection brings to the world. And cry out to all without fear or hesitation, "Christ is risen, truly he's risen, with love in our resurrected Lord." Gerasmos, Metropolitan of San Francisco. As we prepare to darken the church, as Father Nadim said so beautifully this morning, that the Lord wants to duke it out with the evil. And he wants to duke it out with any evil part of your heart, any part that's not filled with light. He wants to come in and open spaces for your vessel to be light, for your body to be light, for your mind to be light. So as the church is darkened, the priest is going to come out, again reflecting the light of Christ coming from the tomb into your hearts, into your life, and we'll make a procession. The altar boys will go out through the back and the side door, because it'll be so congested. We're going to go around the church, meet up on the front, and offer the gospel reading. May we again get out of our heads and into our hearts. Thank God for his love for you and me.
We've also been asked to universally sing the same Christos Anesti and the same Christ is Risen, and that music is in your church bulletin. The one that is in the service book is not exactly correct, so you're going to want to really follow the Christos Anesti that we're singing in the church bulletin that you received out the door. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, they went to the tomb when the sun had risen, and they were saying to one another, "Who will roll the stone away for us from the door of the tomb?" And looking up, they saw that the stone was rolled back, for it was very large. And entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, dressed in a white robe, and they were amazed. And he said to them, "Do not be amazed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He is risen, but he is not here. See the place where they laid him. But go tell his disciples and Peter that he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him as he told you." And they went out and fled from the tomb. For trembling and astonishment had come upon them, and they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid.
Glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you.
Glory to the holy consubstantial life, even undivided Trinity, always, now, and ever, into the ages of ages. Yeah.
But go and proclaim the good news unto his disciples.
This is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Pascha of delight, Pascha, the Lord's Pascha, the oven of all Pascha has done for us today. Let us embrace each other with joy, for it is Pascha, a Pascha delivered from sorrow. For Christ is shown for today, the tomb as the bridal chamber.
destroyed Hades, power, and you rose the victor. Christ God saying to the myrrh-bearers, hail, and granting peace to your disciples who raise up the fallen. And granting peace unto the disciples who raise up the fallen.
Before dawn, the myrrh-bearing maidens seek as the day spring the sun who existed before the sun. Now setting in the tomb, cry to one another, come friends, let us anoint the life-giving and embedded entombed body which was raised the fallen Adam in the body as he lay in the grave. Come, let us make haste like the magi and worship and bring spices and gifts to the old, no longer wrapped in swaddling clothes, but to the shroud, in a shroud. Let us weep and exclaim, arise, Master, you who raise up the fallen.
Arise, Master, you who raise up the fallen.
Today on April 20th, we commemorate the venerable father, Trigenes of the Hair Shirt. On the holy and great Sunday of Pascha, we celebrate the life-giving resurrection of our Lord, God and Savior Christ, Jesus Christ. Descending alone to grapple with Hades, Christ emerged with the many spoils of victory. To him be the dominion to the endless ages.
Having beheld the resurrection of Christ, let us worship the Holy Lord Jesus, the only sinless one. We venerate your cross, O Christ, and your holy resurrection we praise and glorify. For you are our God, and we know no other. It is your name we invoke. Come, all you faithful, let us worship Christ's holy resurrection. For behold, through the cross, joy has come to all the world. Blessed the Lord, let us praise his resurrection, for enduring the cross as for us he destroyed death by death.
Risen from the grave as he foretold, Jesus has given us eternal life in his great mercy.
He who freed the youth from the furnace, becoming man, suffers as a mortal, and through the passion calls mortal flesh. The comeliness of immortality, the blessed of the fathers, God most glorious.
We praise, we bless, and we worship the Lord.
On the third day,
Yeah.
again in peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help you to save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious
nation.
With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
All the heavenly powers praise you and offer up glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever.
Amen.
The King and Lord, though you slept as a mortal, you rose in 3 days, raising up Adam from corruption and annulling death. A Pascha of immortality, salvation of the
your condescension, befitting divinity, we pray. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
of the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, distress, let us pray to the Lord. Save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, Lord.
Lord our God, whose power is beyond compare, whose glory is beyond understanding, whose mercy is boundless and love for us is ineffable, look upon us and upon this holy house in your compassion, and grant to us and to those who pray with us your abundant mercy. For to you belong all glory, honor, worship, to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. And to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Shout with joy to God, all the earth.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, Savior, save us.
Sing to his name, give glory to his praises.
As blessed be as his Theotokos, so dear, so sonimas.
God, how awesome are your works.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, Savior, save us.
Let all the earth worship you and sing praises to you.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, Savior, save us. Oh.
commit ourselves and one another in the whole life of Christ, our God.
To you, O Lord.
Lord, you have given us grace to offer these common prayers with one heart. You have promised to grant the request of two or three gathered in your name. Fulfill now the petitions of your servants for our benefit, giving us the knowledge of your truth in this world, and granting us everlasting life in the world to come.
For you are a good and loving God, and you will give glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let God arise, let his enemies be scattered, and let them all hate him flee from before him.
Jesus.
adorn them with a gift, your grace. You give wisdom and understanding to the supplicant. You not overlook the sinner, but have established repentance as a way of salvation. Give enable us, your lowly and worthy servants, to stand this hour before the glory of your holy altar and talk to you to worship and praise. Master, accept the Christ holy hymn also from the lips of us sinners, and visit us in your goodness, forgive our voluntary and involuntary transgressions. Sanctify our souls and bodies, and grant that we may worship and serve you in holiness all the days of our lives. By the intercession of the holy Theotokos, and of all the saints who please you in our creations. For you are holy, our God, and you give glory to the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and into the ages of ages.
Amen.
On page 293, you will find the hymn.
As many of you as have been baptized into Christ have clothed yourselves in Christ. Alleluia. All seas be storms and the deeps be dead. Please so with your spirit.
the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came for testimony to bear witness to the light, that all might believe through him. He was not the light, but was to bear witness to the light. The true light that enlightens every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, yet the world knew him not. He came to his own, and his own received him not. But to all who received them, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth. We have beheld his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father. John bore witness to him and cried, "This is he of whom I said, he who comes after me ranks before me, for he was before me." And from his fullness have we all received grace upon grace. For the law was given through Moses, and grace and truth came through Jesus Christ.
Glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you.
Just a couple thoughts as we continue this holy day. A lot of us will come and go to the service without a second thought of how our lives should be changed as Christ came to reach deep in your heart and take everything that is dark, that's not following him, that's not connected with him, and open that space into his life. Today the gates of hell are open, the chains are broken, the prison doors are crushed, locks undoing the past and our humanity becoming restored and reunited with his power and the love of God. St. Gregory of Nyssa says this: "Man who is so great and precious, as the scriptures call him, he fell from the value he had by nature. It is like people who slip and fall in mud and get their faces so smeared that even their relatives cannot even recognize him. So man fell in the mud of sin and lost his likeness to God, and in its stead he has, by sin, clothed himself in an image that is of clay and mortal. And this is the image we earnestly counsel him to remove and wash away in the purifying waters of the Christian life. Once this earthly covering is removed, the soul's beauty will once again shine forth. Now the removal of what is foreign is a return to what is natural to man, and this we only achieve by becoming what we once were in the beginning when we were created. Yet to achieve this likeness to God is not within our power nor within any human capacity. It is a gift of God's bounty. For he directly bestowed this divine likeness on our human nature as its creation. By our human efforts, we can merely clear away the accumulated filth of sin and thus allow the hidden beauty of the soul to shine forth. Today is an incredible day. It's about Jesus Christ, but it's about you. Did you ever think about this day that it's about you? That, listen, that the hidden beauty of the soul is to shine forth, that your journey, that your purpose, that your reason to be alive is to shine forth the light of Christ. And many times, I really feel the most neglected relationship, you know what that is? The most neglected relationship, I think people say, is God. The most neglected relationship is ourselves, in its true nature. Because if we really had a relationship with ourselves, in our true nature, we'd be shining the light. But we don't contemplate who we really are. I want to share a story about a beloved friend, a blessed memory, Constantine Charlie the Young. Before he died, we had, I call it, Tuesdays with Charlie. We had, maybe some of you don't know, but Charlie was fighting a brain tumor for a while. The last stage was pretty tough in the last 3 months. We invited him for dinner, a couple of us, and we had a nice dinner, and we we saw movies and hung out together. And the last movie we saw before he died, like 2 months after this movie that we saw, is Flight. Anyone seen Flight? There's a powerful scene at the end. And at the scene at the end, the movie's about a pilot who really saves a lot of people, but he's a drunk and he's an addict. And he has a really strange relationship with his teenage son. To make a long story short, the whole movie is about so he drank on the airplane, and they try to convict him that he was drunk while he was flying the plane, but he saved all these people. To make a long story short, he gets in front of the FAA or whoever they are, the flight board, and they're going to exonerate him, and he's sitting there, and he says, you know, he said, we're going to exonerate you. And he's sitting underneath his breath. He says, I can't do this anymore. I was drunk. I was drunk then, and I'm drunk now. And he convicts himself. He gets sent to prison. And there's a scene in prison a year later, months later, where the son comes to visit him. And they take him out of prison. They take him on the side, put him on the bench. And he's talking, embraces his son, his 18-year-old son. He's going to go to college. And he said, Dad, I need to do My essay is about the most important and influential person that I never met. And I want to interview you. Charlie, me, Gus, we look at each other, it's like, we got a kick in the gut, like it's a problem. The most influential, important person you ever met, who is that? So as we're leaving and Charlie was walking a little bit slow back then. He was shuffling, and back then he had a soft voice. I think when you have cancer, I don't know if it's true, but your voice is soft. And as we're walking, he just stops, and I'm thinking, it's late, I want to go home, I want to go sleep. Charlie's taking his time, and Charlie's going, Father, did you think of the question? I said, what question, Charlie? The question. He says, Charlie, what question? And he stops. Who the most important, influential person you've never met? I said, Charlie, you saw the movie? No, I haven't. So we start walking, and he stops. And he did this thing with his eyes where he kept on bobbing up and down. And he stops, and he looks at me, and I said, Charlie, did you think of that question? And he says, yeah. I said, who is the most important, influential person you've never met? And he looks at me, stops, bam, like radar right in my eyes. He looks at me. And he says, me. Me. I was cut to the heart that day because that was very profound. I want to share it to you, with you, on this holy day. Because for me, that was very holy. The most important, influential person that God created you in His image and likeness that you've never met or come to know, me. And his wife, Karen, was telling me that was a big conversation that night while they were going to sleep about who am I outside of my Microsoft lawyer suit, outside of my world vision executive position, outside of father, mother, father, parent, husband. Who am I? Who are you? And today, we're being invited to really honor the resurrection by realizing who you are. You ever think about who you are? This is a bunch of flesh. You're going to take time. You're going to die at the end of the day. Here's some of the things that I want you to leave here thinking about who you are and praying about who you are and living out in this way. Because Charlie invites us to really contemplate who are you. You are God's image. You're created in God's image. So if you live anything less, there's something going on with you're not really being the human being that you were created to be. It says in the scriptures, we are children of God. It says in the scriptures, you are made a little bit lower than heavenly beings. Do you live that way? Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. You're a sinner. That's a bad word in these days. But don't worry about the word. The word means you're broken. You're missing the mark. If you're not making the mark of really living out who you are as a sacred vessel of the Holy Spirit, then we've got something wrong. The resurrection is about you and me as Christ came to restore you and me and all of creation. So today, I want you to think about all the false idols that you created in your mind and heart that keep you away from God. Your work, your ego, your ethnicity, your sexuality, anything that gets in the way of your true divine nature, we got to talk about, because this is what this day is about. Jesus came not just for funny games. He came to restore you at the core, so you can be living saints. Mother Teresa said, becoming a saint is not the privilege of the few, it's everyone's duty. So your job is to honor your humanity. And your true human nature is godlike. So if anything is getting in the way, and I'll give you one thing that's going to get in the way, and this is what we want to, at least for those in Holy Apostles, and for those who are not. One thing that's going to get in the way, except the garden that happened, is fear. Anytime you notice fear, you watch what's going to happen. It's going to disconnect your head and your heart. And the Lord says, fear and love can't coexist. And fear is not, and so fear or peace is not, so we want peace in our lives. So peace is not putting down our weapons, signing peace treaties. Peace is the absence of fear. When you have the absence of fear, you can lay your head on your pillow and go to sleep. Today, the Lord wants you to have peace, to have it in abundance. Today, in His resurrection, He wants to restore you deep down and carve out anything, any rotting thing that's keeping you from being holy, from being alive and awake and peaceful and compassionate and graceful. May we continue the liturgy knowing that your personality today is defined by His resurrection. Amen. And His resurrection is defined by your personality. So we are together working with this. So may we do our best to shove aside anything that gets us to fear and tremble and have anxiety and worry and doubt. Because we have a resurrected Lord who came to take all that away. And may we work towards that, becoming vessels of the light. Amen. Amen. Again, we bow before you, praying you, O blue, loving God, hear us at the gate, and cleanse our souls and bodies from every divine and precious spirit, and grant that we can stand before you on the altar without blame or condemnation. Grant also, God, prophets of my faith, spiritual servants, and faithful, to pray with us, so that we always worship you forever, and God, partake of your mystery. Without blame or condemnation, become worthy of your heavenly kingdom. And grant that always, guarded by your power, we give glory to you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and in the ages of ages.
Amen.
upon us and protect us, O God, by your grace. Totally peaceful and sinless day, let us ask the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
An angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of all our souls and bodies, let us ask the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
Forgiveness, remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
What is good and beneficial to our souls and for peace in the world, let us ask the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
For the completion of our lives in peace and repentance, let us ask the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
Enter our lives peaceful without shame and suffering, and for a good account before the awesome judgment seat of Christ, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
In our most holy, pure, blessed,
holy Theotokos,
with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ, our God.
To you, O Lord.
From those who call upon you with their whole heart. Receive all the souls of the prayer of our sinners and let it reach your holy altar. Enable us to bring before you gifts and spiritual sacrifices for our sins and for the transgressions of the people. Make us worthy to find grace in your presence, that our sacrifice may be pleasing to you, and that your good and gracious spirit may abide with us, with the gifts you have presented and with all your people. Through the mercies of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed together, with your holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
Amen.
Christ and love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let's lift up our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord.
It is proper and right.
We bless you, pray you, thank you, worship you, and all places in your dominion. You are God, ineffable, beyond comprehension, invisible, beyond understanding, existing forever and always the same. You and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit. You brought us into being out of nothing, and we fell away, you raised us up again. You did not cease doing everything until you led us to the kingdom of heaven and granted us your kingdom to come. For all these things we thank you and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit, for all the things we know, for all the things we do not know, for the blessings seen and unseen that have been bestowed upon us. We also thank you for this liturgy which you're pleased to accept from our hands. Even though you're surrounded by thousands of archangels, tens of thousands of angels, by the cherubim, seraphim, 16 many eyes soaring with their wings, singing the victory and proclaiming, crying out loud and saying,
Holy,
oh.
safe, honorable. Help me for many years by the teaching the word of your truth. Remember also, Lord, those of each of us called to mind.
Not a wedding garment, and being bound up, I shall be cast out by the angels. In your my soul and save me. Loving Master, Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holy gifts lead to my condemnation, because of my unworthiness, but for the cleansing and sanctification of soul and body, and the pledge of future life and kingdom.
It is good for me to bring to God,
and to place in him the hope of my salvation.
Receive me today, O Son of God, as a partaker of your mystical supper. I will not betray your mysteries to your enemies, nor give you a kiss as to Judas, but as the thief I confess you. Remember me, Lord, in your kingdom.
Let all
of ages.
In your holiness, as we meditate on your righteousness all the day long. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Let us be attentive and perceive the divine holy pure of our life, you know, and mysteries of Christ. Let us worthily give thanks to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, in your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Pray for a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day. Let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our Lord. Protect the whole body of your church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them in return by your divine power. Do not forsake us who hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your church, to the clergy, those in public service, to all your people. For every good and perfect gift is from above, coming from you, the Father of lights. And to you we give glory, thanksgiving, and worship to the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and in the ages of ages. Some have even been as late as the ninth hour. Come forward, do not be at loss. If any of you have arrived only at the 11th hour, do not be dismayed for being late. The Master is gracious. He accepts the last even as first. He gives rest to those of the 11th hour as well as those who labor from the first. He is lenient with his last while looking after the first. The one he gives to the other he gives freely. He accepts the labors and welcomes the effort, honors the deed, but commends the intent. So all of you, enter into the joy of our Lord. First and second, share the bounty, rich and poor alike. Celebrate together. Sober or heedless, honor the day. Those who fasted and those who did not, rejoice today. The table is full. Everyone is fared sumptuously. The calf is fatted. No one go away hungry. Everyone savor the banquet of the faith. Relish the riches of his goodness. No one need lament poverty, for the kingdom is seen as universal. No one need grieve over sins, forgiveness is dawned from the tomb. No one need to fear death, the Savior's death has freed us all from it. While his captive, he stifled it. He despoiled Hades as he descended into it. It was angered when it was tasted his flesh, for seeing this Isaiah proclaimed. Hades, he said, was bitter.
It was bitter.
When he met you below, it was bitter because it was abolished. It was bitter.
It was bitter.
Because it was mocked. It was bitter.
It was bitter.
Because it was annihilated. It was bitter.
It was bitter.
Because it was a change. It took a body and met God face to face. It took earth and encountered heaven. It took what could be seen as was crushed by what could not be seen. Death, where is your sting? Hades, where is your victory? Christ is risen.
Truly he is risen.
Death is overthrown. Christ is risen.
Truly he is risen.
Demons have fallen. Christ is risen.
Truly he is risen.
Angels rejoice. Christ is risen.
Truly he is risen.
Life is set free. Christ is risen.
Truly he is risen.
The tomb is empty of the dead, for Christ is risen from the dead as the first to the fallen asleep. To him be the power and glory to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever into the ages of ages.
Amen.
Christ is risen from the dead. By death can we down upon death and to those in the tomb he has granted life. He shows on Hades' dead throne the anathema,
Christos Anesi, the Lord is risen, may we live
Pascha, bring us your blessings. A, in the food and drink of your servants, prayer for you, only now and ever to the age of the babies.
Amen.
Anything I forgot? Noelle's here. Thank you, Noelle. It's so good to have you here. God bless you.
I left you a message, but I remembered what you said about a couple of years ago about Easter bringing. But you didn't tell I
know you. Amen. I just got the message. Sweet Noelle's been with us. She finds herself. She's lost her sight, but she finds her sight in many beautiful ways. Thank you.
Pray for energy.
Amen. God bless you. You're all invited to join us for a bite and breaking the fast, sharing some of our meals here. And I'll offer you an egg plug and DP you off to the dinner. Who's got a gray Ford Ranger? It's too late now. Your battery's probably dead. 3 hours ago. California, any Californians here? 87043K1.
It's not out anymore.
I have probably done by now. By the way, I want to hold on one last thing. I don't know what it is, but they're talking, at least at Holy Apostles, about how to make a red egg red. And there's drama. Like some people say, like, my eggs are pink and my eggs are this color, but this egg here, over this one, it's kind of like Art Nouveau, like the spot sign. I kind of watch myself. Thank you all for walking the eggs, pink, red, whatever they are.
And services are what time tomorrow?
Tomorrow is 1 o'clock. You're all welcome. 1 o'clock is going to be a beautiful day. Vespers and our great feast is always enjoyed by everyone. Thank you. Thank
you. Son is risen from his grave.
Christ, having risen from the grave as he foretold, has bestowed on us eternal life and greater mercy. Come, let us drink of his grace, and at once receive the thorn from the barren cross, but from the fount of incorruption, which springs forth from the tomb of Christ, in whom we are established. Glory to your holy resurrection, O Lord. Now all things are filled with light, heaven and earth are the deepest parts of the earth. Let all creation celebrate the rising of Christ, in which it is established. Glory to your holy resurrection, O Lord. Yesterday I was buried with you, O Christ. Today I arose in the resurrection. Yesterday I was crucified with you. O Savior, glorify me with yourself in your kingdom. Christ is risen from the dead, by death he has trespassed upon death, and on those in the tombs he is bestowing life. Jesus, having risen from the grave as he foretold, has bestowed on us eternal life and great mercy. He is higher prophet, harp on foot, now stands with Christ in holy angel. He is like a shining angel who cries.